Here we go, boys. Last time. May Allah.
Dear Lord, the vows to go through life.
Dear Lord, the vows to go through life.
We ask for chance, it's fair.
We ask for a chance, it's fair.
Chance to go our stride.
Chance to go our stride.
A chance to do or dare.
A chance to do or dare.
If we should win.
We should win.
Let it be by the code.
Let it be by the code.
Faith not hell high.
Faith not hell high.
If we should lose.
We should lose.
Let's stand by the road.
Let's stand by the road.
And cheers when it's go by.
And cheers when it's go by.
Down by day.
Down by day.
We get better, better.
We get better, better.
Do we can't be beat.
Do we can't be beat.
Won't be beat.
Won't be beat. Ah!
I saw three. One, two, three.
Ah!
Let's go, boy! Make a man miss! Yes!
Once I rose above the noise and confusion, just to get a glimpse beyond this illusion. I was soaring ever higher, but I flew too high. Though my eyes could see, I still was a blind man. Though my mind could think, I still was a madman. I hear the voices when I'm dreaming.
I'm gonna practice every single day. Definitely something new. Spending like 4 hours of my life with some guys I just met this past year is pretty crazy. The whole sense of family, I guess, it's new. I haven't been on a team for 3 years. I used to play lacrosse, and it's back now. And now that I'm a senior, it's probably the greatest feeling.
Season is it's probably gonna be my most favorite season because I get to play with all the seniors. You, Joey, John, Kyle. It's my last year with them, and actually playing with them. It's just, I'm trying to cherish every moment I have.
All my friends and my Pee Wee friends play for Sabino, and they all went there, because they think, oh, it's Sabino, we're gonna whip everybody's butts.
Honestly, it's purely pride. I'm going in with my head up, of course, but I just want to do everything I can, and I want my teammates to do the best they can. I don't care if we win or lose. It's for pride. I want everyone to do the best they can.
Oh, it's everything. This game's personal. I've known these kids for a long time. I'm not trying to start any fights. I know Drew Dixon's talking smack, but I don't want any of that. I just want to go out there and play, leave my heart on the field.
No, because I'm a pussy and I sit all over my mouth. I joined football 6 months ago, and this is my second year at the school. I haven't been here for 2 full years yet. I came from Sabino, if you didn't know.
Hey, shut up!
I'll tell you right now, the past 4 months, I have met the best friends that I've ever met, and I know that I'm going to keep these guys I met 4 months ago for the rest of my life. Joey, John, Tanner, Noah, Jacob, all you guys, honestly. I love you guys. You guys are my family right now. Like, I just came into football and you guys just picked me right up like I was your brother. Like, that is the greatest feeling in the world. And I just want to let you guys know how happy I am to have you guys. Thank you guys.
Thank you.
train for the love of football, okay?
Yes, sir.
That's why we're here. We're here to play for the love of football.
The only thing these guys out here can ask you guys to do is go 110% the whole game, okay?
I've seen glimpses of you guys being great, and I've seen glimpses of you guys being the last team in 3A, okay? But guess what? We're not that. And tonight is your chance to prove it. See what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
We had a family member die. So that's the person that you should be playing for. That's the exact person you should be playing for. Because guess what? That person tonight's going to give his all. So, y'all are going to ask to give your all. You guys need to be out here, be a family, be a unit. Let's march down the field like the tank we are, guys. What does Tanque Verde mean?
Green tank.
Tanque Verde means green tank, fellas. A tank means a lot to me. It saved my life. So, with that being said, guys, be a unit. Be that tank. Let's drive him down the field. Let's punch him in their mouths from the beginning, okay?
Yes, sir.
Let's be that dark horse tonight. Let's be that one nobody thinks about. Alright? Let's go out here and let's shock the world. Only thing I can ever ask from you guys is for you guys to play at 110%. 110%. Give it your all. As while I'm up there in that booth calling stuff down for the defense, I'm going to put you in the right positions. It's up to you guys to do what you're supposed to do. We haven't practiced this long and this hard for nothing. Let's do it, guys. Let's get out here and let's shock the world.
Here we go, boy.
Two by two, boys. Two by two.
Be the big dog. Show them that we aren't scared to do it. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Let's do it, man. Before I go up here. Game time on.
Let's go. We're gonna drive down the field. Let's go.
Let's do it.
Hawks on three. 1, 2, 3.
Hawks. Thank you.
in the rest of the game. Block that corner.
Try to hit the edges. So here's what you do. Center right here. Give me the center. Hurry, because we have to go. Give my center, my guards, and my tackle.
Half, so
yeah, we got to start walking. Hurry up. Where's my two guards and my tackle? Come on. Hurry, guys. Come on. Listen. Get your split sight on snap. You three are down, and you two on the end are down. Take these middle guys and stop them. We're going to use the wing back and the other guy to block the way we're running. We don't care about away from the way we're running. We're going to fight the left.
Well, they were clearly just bigger than us. They've been kids that have been playing for, I don't know, they've probably been playing since freshman year all together on the freshman squad. They have that chemistry that we really don't.
They were a lot bigger than us. They have been playing as a team, like Joey said, since freshman year together. And if you were to take the team that we have today and you were to put them together, and have them playing since freshman year, by our senior year, we'd be unstoppable.
We're just a bunch of seniors that we, what are there, 8-9 seniors on our team, and then the rest are just sophomores and freshmen that are just now learning football. There's a junior on our team that this is his first year playing football ever, and he's already starting varsity for us, so just mistakes that happen that we could have been more disciplined, but it's just the experience that we lost it.
It's just a bond that each family, each team has that takes more than just 6 months to build up. It takes more than just 6 months to have that true bondship. And as you can tell by looking at our team, we have people who are part of our group, are part of our team, but they still like to wander off on their own. And that's not how teams, or that's not how families work. Families work as a unit, families work together, and that's honestly what the Sabino players had over us.
Day before the game, I was really sick. Day of the game, I was still sick, but I was like, you know, I can't miss this. During the game, I wasn't playing offense at all. I was just playing defense, kick return, returning a couple kicks. I had a couple good kick returns. And then, whatever Joey said, I don't even care, he got hurt. And we were all right. And then Tanner got hurt. Tanner's like sitting there, and he's like, I think I broke my arm. And that's when stuff started to like go down.
Mentally, for everybody else, what was going through their head was, we're screwed. We're boned. We don't know what else to do, because we had to have third string, fourth string center in. We had to have a third string quarterback.
Just with the injury, I was carrying the ball, and I got pushed back, and I landed on the ball, and then I got dogpiled on. Just good gang tackling by them, and it was just bad. It was just missed luck that it landed on my ribs.
I mean, we had Eric playing a position that he's never played before and never even done one single practice for.
You know, I had to go in at quarterback. I've never practiced quarterback. Phil came out, and he was like, all right, yeah, so Eric, you're going to be quarterback and just hand the ball to Marlo. I was like, wait, what? And then that wasn't even the worst, because during like the third, maybe fourth quarter, Phil comes out because he has to give me the play every time. He comes out and he's just like, all right, Eric, here's a play. Fake the ball to Marlo, throw the deep ball to me. And I'm like, oh, what? And he's like, fake to Marlo, throw the deep ball to me. And I was like, hold on, deep ball, 20 yards, 50 yards? Because I can't do either. But, you know, it wasn't that bad. He almost caught it, actually. I faked the ball to Marlo, threw it. Got hit while throwing it, and like I knew it was a bad throw because I was rushed, but I just got thrown straight into the ground, and I hear a bunch of cheering, and I was just thinking to myself, like, no way. But I got up, and Joey just got hurt. Tanner got hurt. That's when it started getting bad. Joey's honestly like throwing shade. He's not a good player at all. I don't, like, if he was around here, he'd probably like beat me, but he's not good. Tanner. No, he was all right.
My mentality, honestly, I was angry. I was angry at the fact that they cheap-shotted one of my best friends and that they cheap-shotted another one of my best friends. The fact that they were even injured was the fact that I was playing for them. I was playing for the people who... I was playing for Joey, I was playing for Tanner, I was playing for everybody on the sideline who couldn't play. Because, think about it, those people, the guys on the sideline didn't have the chance to show them their anger. They didn't have the chance to show them how mad they were. They didn't have the chance to show them what was up. And that was my goal at the time, was to show them that we aren't just some team that was going to be rolled over. They already put two of our players out. They weren't going to put another one.
Overall, as a team, I think that we could have done better because we kind of, after the third possession, we were, like, the first couple of possessions, we were attacking them. And then the other, we were just playing to survive the game. We were just playing afraid after a couple of our starters went out.
I mean, you know the score. That kind of says it. We didn't do too good. 63-0. I mean, we started off fine. We started off perfectly fine. But then we started falling apart. We started, like, blaming each other for everything. Our line stopped blocking. Everybody stopped blocking. People were running scared, and it was just nothing you can do when stuff like that happens.
Get off of me, please.
It's going to be hard to bounce back from a game where you didn't score at all. We did it week two, actually, Sam and Will, after we didn't score against Palo Verde. But, I mean, it's going to be really tough, but we can do it. Our line just, when our line blocks, and I've seen it in us, it's scary when we start to block and everything. I'm playing running back this week. I expect at least 2 touchdowns. Joey's playing fullback. I expect him to get hurt because he's just fat. So.
You're a
pussy. Oh, bounced back very nicely, actually, like, better than I expected. Like, we didn't go into that game with our heads down because we're just like, shit, I don't care. These guys aren't as good as Sabino was. We can fight with these guys. We can hang with them.
Oh, that was tough. I think it was worse on the coaches more than it was on the players too, because it was just so devastating for all of us. But it was definitely hard on the players too. And nobody likes to try to, you know, work yourself up to win after a loss. But you know, that's what we got to do.
The team's mentality. I know it's tough for everyone to come back and win a game after we lost that bad. But it's tough mentally, but we pulled it through. We pulled through and did it, so.
I really hope people can really pick themselves up after losing how we did to Sabino and find it in them to pick up performance and get a win out of it.
I'm expecting to do really well. Like, if our line can block, I feel like we could put up pretty good amount of points, and just our defense has been really good leading up.
My expectation for the Catalina game is to win. I've been watching film all week on them, and honestly, to me, they don't seem that great. I know we've said that about many teams before, but for some reason, watching this Catalina team, it feels a lot different than any other game going into. I feel like this game's going to be the one for us to come back and finally get that streak going.
Dear Lord, vows to go through life.
Dear Lord, vows to go through life.
We ask for a chance of fair.
We ask for a chance of fair.
Chance to go stride.
Chance to go stride.
Chance to do or dare.
Chance to do or dare.
If we shall win.
We shall win.
Let it be by the code.
Let it be by the code.
Faith not held high.
Faith not held high.
We shall lose.
We shall lose.
Let's stand by the road.
Let's stand by the road.
And cheers winds go by.
And cheers winds go by.
Day by day.
Day by day.
We get better, better.
We get better, better.
To a champion beat.
To a champion beat.
Won't be beat.
Won't be beat.
Hawks on three. One, two, three.
Hawks.
This ref always gets in the way.
You're the starting wideout. He's the wing.
The what?
He's the slot. Eric's the running back. You're the.
Set the tone early, baby. Set the tone early. Here we go. Off squad, all three. One, two, three.
All four.
Have fun. Let's go. Have fun.
Over here.
Hey, let's go.
Oh.
Come down in the seat, because it's taking you forever to go from here to here, right? You just line up, move over the seat, and walk into it, and go. Your job's not the B, your job's not the A, it's the backside guy. You handle what you're supposed to handle.
Tell John, once you guys
John.
That step of that back, you gotta go.
John! When you see him move, you gotta go, baby!
One and to keep pushing hard in practice, keep pushing hard every day to try to get that push for our wins, that ability to believe that we're not just a pair of takeaway losers.
Our mindset is basically working on offense, defense, special teams, and trying to get us to perfect those things that we have trouble with, and just to make sure we have no mistakes during games so we can win.
There comes a point in everybody's life where they have to make a decision on aspects of their life that they don't want to make. These are decisions that no one wants anyone to ever make. But sometimes they have to happen for certain reasons. When I think about my time on the football team, it's just happiness and fun times with all of my friends. And to know that one play could end it is just, I can't explain it. You know, life happens. You're forced to make decisions sometimes that you don't want to make. And that's the situation that I'm in today. When I got hit and I got that concussion, it never occurred to me that it could spiral into something that could end my season. Never would have occurred to me that that was something that would happen. I'm done. My concussion has forced me to not go on the field anymore. To never be able to play football again. And realistically, my football career is over. I've put 4 years into this program. Me and John are the only two remaining from our freshman squad. We're the only two that can say that we have gone through this program for 4 years together. And, you know, John, I know you're watching. You're my brother, man. We've been through a lot together. And this is just another bump in the road. But we will finish what we started together. And to everyone else, just thank you for... I always envisioned how my last game would be. You know, the last time I'd be on the field, how I'd get the feeling that I always got. How I'd be on the field, all my friends in the stands, family, because it'd be senior night, and everyone would be there cheering on the seniors. Just looking up into the lights and looking into the stands, just taking it all in. It's not happening. I would just like to thank my family for always having my back and supporting me through everything. My teammates, thank you guys for being my second family and being there for me when I really, really need it, because without you guys, it would be so hard. I need every single one of you. You guys are all my family, and you all always will be. I'd like to thank my coaches, Coach Jay, Coach Q, Coach Samoy, Coach B. You guys have done more for me than you know you have. And thank you for mentoring me and giving me the chances to be a football player. Coach Q, I'm still coming for that hug on senior night. Don't think it's not happening. And thank you to my friends and to everyone else. Thank you.
This game means everything to me because this is going to be my first game, and this is going to be my first homecoming game, and I'm starting. That's a really big deal for me.
Oh, it's honestly everything, because homecoming is not only the only chance we get to represent our school as a whole, but we get to represent in front of our family, and we get to show all of our coaches, and my coach being my dad. It means a lot to me, and I do never want to lose homecoming, and so there's a lot riding on the line. And in my family, it's important too, because with my dad being my coach, and then my grandpa's also been a football coach for 30 plus years, and it just runs in our family. We don't lose homecoming. It's just not something you want to do.
It's going to be very, very emotional. I know Eric's going to be upset. I know Joe's going to be upset. It's my last homecoming of a senior year on this football team. I've been with this program for 4 years. Me and Jack are the only ones who've ever been, only ones left who've been with Tanque Verde for 4 years. I mean, I've been through this football program, through its goods, its bads, and its worst. And right now, we're honestly in our best.
Yeah. I mean, it was a good game. We worked hard. We did our assignments. We did our jobs. Just hope we can do that same thing next week.
Keep feeling good. It's always nice to be on a really good win streak, especially after winning 55-12. Like, that's such a big number. We beat them by so much. I think that's the first time that Tanque Verde's ever clocked somebody.
It made me feel really good, actually. I didn't expect me to do that well with throwing one touchdown and having one rushing touchdown from a QB sneak.
Scooter was Coach B's brother. He got into a car accident and got really badly hurt. So we just wanted to devote that game to him, just to know that Coach B, like, we're always behind his back and we're always there for his family, because he is our family, and then whoever his family is, he's our family as well.
Chance to equal our stride.
Chance to equal our stride.
Chance to do it there.
Chance to do it there.
If we should win.
If we should win.
Let it be by the code.
Let it be by the code.
Faith and honor held high.
Faith and honor held high.
If we should lose.
We should lose.
Let's stand by the road.
Let's stand by the road.
And cheers, winners go by.
And cheers, winners go by.
Day by day.
Day by day.
We get better, better.
We get better, better.
Do it, can't be beat.
Do it, can't be beat.
Whoa, beat, beat.
Whoa, beat, beat. Ah!
Hush on three. One, two, three.
Hush. Eat it like groceries.
Make sure you get it done.
I'm gonna be sitting there booth watching. Backside guys, who's the enemy?
Number?
Yeah.
Number five.
You gotta know your enemy, guys. You gotta know your enemy. Alright? Colton, you gotta handle business, right? I don't have to worry about you blitzing, do it. Now, John, remember, dude, and Bear, you're going
backside.
He has backside feet, Colton has front side feet. You two got quarterback, Colton got running back. Got it? Now, nose guards. If you're a nose guard, I need for you to stand by Coach B so you guys can get rotated in, all right? Brandon, you need to prepare, all right? Because the first time I see Jordan go on half speed, he's coming up,
all right? And he's going to last team.
You said the first time he sees it.
First time I see you go low speed, dude.
You may not.
You don't. If you start getting pushed around and not doing your job, you're coming up.
That's not happy.
I hope not. I pray. Now, hey! Hey! Everybody convinced I get this prayer done, guys.
Punch him in the mouth!
One more time. What we gonna do?
Punch him in the mouth!
Now, hey, the same way we started the game last week, getting hyped right before we take the field, on the sideline. That will be a tradition staying here, got it?
Yes, sir.
Eric, where's Eric? He's getting taped. Hey, welcome back, Eric. Make sure I'm gonna be up there, but watch. I shouldn't have to say, Joe, Eric, do this. Take the initiative, get them hyped right before we get done, right?
Yes, sir.
All right, fellas, I love you. And let's go punch him in the mouth, all right?
Punch him in the mouth. Yeah.
Chemicals.
where do we go get the ball?
High point.
Coach. So if we would have stopped and we would have come back to the ball, there's no way to tip that ball.
We watch film because we need to know what the opponent's going to do, what their tendencies are, and to make plays that'll shut down their offense or put up big plays against their defense.
You know, watching film is just important just so we see the other team and know what we're going up against, and so we can visualize it in our head. Like, I do things a lot better when I can see it and know how to do it, and film is the next best thing to actually doing it and getting the muscle memory for it.
I think watching film is important because, like that old saying, like, knowing is like half the battle. So you gotta know your opponent before like you play them, or you would honestly just kind of get your ass kicked every time. And yeah, like, I mean, you just gotta like study up, because that's half of what we're doing out here.
We rushed for 463 yards Friday. Okay? We did a lot of things this season that they haven't done. As a team, we've already rushed for over 1,600 yards. Okay? We have the top rusher in the conference. We're second in touchdowns in the conference. Did you guys know that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Our rusher has 200 more yards than the next closest guy in the league. Our tackler, we have the number one tackler in the 3A with the most tackles. The only reason we don't win is because we make stupid mistakes. We don't catch throws. We fumble the ball. We tighten that up, guys, and you can go in this week, but this week's going to be the test week. It's not going to be like playing Catalina and Santa Rita. It's going to be a little bit tougher, man. And we're playing on turf. We're not playing on grass this week, man. Sarita has a turf field, man. So we're going to have to keep our heads right. You're going to have to protect yourself. You're going to have to play well. But we can beat them if we execute. But it's going to be tough, man. We're going to have to execute. Lower those penalties. Block who we're supposed to block. And turn the ball north and south. Get first downs. What do first downs turn into?
Touchdowns.
Right, because they get frustrated. They try to blitz or gamble. As long as we can block and run our base plays, guys, we can win Friday. So I need you guys to buy in. We need to work the 7-second drill today. We've got the 7-second drill down. We're going to hit the sled. We're going to do our kick and punt return drill. I think it made a big difference. Defense walkthrough. We need to learn where we need to align. We're going to probably stay in bear a lot because they like to hit two guys at the point of attack. Our strong safety and free safety are going to have to come up and tackle this week like linebackers. So we may make some adjustments there. Punt return. We'll do a couple punt returns. TMO, alignment assignment. We're going to work a lot against the backs today against those blitzes. Friday we saw a few weird stunts. We were one guy away from breaking our sweep again. We're this close to getting there, guys. It's going to happen. And we're going to have two big teams. We'll be able to hit them on both sides this week. The other thing we got to work is our waggle sprints. We're going to run again today to end practice for conditioning. We'll do 700 yards. We're going to waggle it up, okay? Sarita's D is a 4-4. Their outside ends, almost 90% come outside, and their guys come inside. So we're going to work against that, and they will line up in the double A gaps. They're going to put a guy right on top of the center, which is perfect. And that's it, man. And we just got to fix our sweep. And I've got to play so we can hit a quick pass to our tight, to our split. We'll bring him in tight, and we'll get him in at six, okay? It'll be like stealing like we did this week, but it'll require a little finesse with the throw. Can we do that?
Yes, sir.
All right, guys, it's 3:28. Everybody's on the field 17 minutes, ready to go, right? Do it. Roll. Just like that. Tuck your head and roll. Okay, guys, we're gonna be down on the ground. You're gonna roll. Okay, get ready. When I say roll, you roll. Get ready. When you roll and roll over, you get back in the stance. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Roll. Get set.
That was so fucking.
Get set. Roll. Get set. Get set. It's fine. Come on. Get set. Ready. Set. Roll. Okay, everybody lay facing that way.
Have fun throwing up. Have fun throwing up.
I'm so hungry.
No, I live, I'm scared.
Bro,
where are you?
Where am I?
Right the sideline? I can't tell.
Hi, Marvel.
I'm going to
win.
Don't fuck with me like
that.
You're good, Mark. You're good. Mark, you're good. You're good, okay? You're good. You're good. You're good.
No, stay there, John. John, don't move. Stay down.
Sean, you dummy.
Stay in line. Leapfrog, let's go. Get your head down so you don't hit him in the nuts.
Ow.
Boy, you don't play leapfrog with the uniform. Stay. Stay, go.
This is why I don't play leapfrog.
Go, hurry up. John, get down. Get a proper stance, you jerk. Go. Hurry up. Leapfrog. Kyle's going to win. Get your head down. Stay down. Get a good stance. Hurry up, baby. To the sled. Let's go.
I spend pretty much the whole bus ride with my head down, just kind of like focusing on what my job is. So when I get off the bus, like I'm just ready. Like, I'm ready to play. I'm ready to go. Like, let's do this.
Focus on what we got to do. Thinking over your job, who you block, on what plays.
I basically focus on all the plays I'm going to do and all the big plays, tackles, anything that I can do to make our team.
I think it's pretty cool just because I haven't done too many crazy things like that. I haven't really made like any big records or anything ever on a sports team. So I think it'll be pretty cool.
It means a lot. Our team has been known for really filling tall orders like this game's gonna be. But you know, we also haven't been known for winning. We haven't been known for suiting up more than 12 guys. And we surprised a lot of people this year. We've done some really cool things. I think we can keep going.
Honestly, it's leaving behind like this year's seniors like legacy. I think that'd be great. Like, if like me, Joey, and like all the other seniors, we could like make history for like before we leave, and I think that'd be great.
Let's go! Bring it in! Dear Lord, the battles will go through life.
Dear Lord, the battles will go through life.
We ask for chance to spare.
We ask for chance to spare.
Chance to equal our stride.
Chance to equal our stride.
Chance to do or dare.
Chance to do or dare.
If we should win.
If we should win.
Let it be by the code.
Let it be by the code.
Faith in honor held high.
Faith in honor held high.
If we should lose.
If we should lose.
Let's stand by the road.
Let's stand by the road.
Ensure as winners go by.
Ensure as winners go by.
Day by day.
Day by day.
We get better, better.
We get better, better.
Do we can't be beat.
Do we can't be beat.
Whoa, be beat.
Whoa, be beat. Ah!
Hawks on three. One, two, three.
Hawks.
Thank you.
game that you played. Tell me, why the hell did we get whooped? Come here, coach. Let me show you something. Offensive line, this is what I'm seeing. This is 44. Brandon, you've done this numerous times. John, I don't know what the hell you're doing. And Mark, you're doing the same. Zach, go. Is that how we block? That's what y'all doing. Or, Brandon, I see you do this. Y'all better wake up. Because your record can go just like this. This fast. Some of you only have 2 games left. You better give it your damn all.
Can't let them out of the backfield. D-line, you gotta quit standing up. I know you're playing hard, guys. Alex and Brandon and all you guys inside, you guys need to beat pit bulls in the gaps. Quit letting that guy through the middle of the field. If you guys are in both A gaps and both B gaps, we should be good to go. But if you guys are standing up in those gaps and getting going back, he can run the ball right up the middle. We can't have that. Outside backers, don't over pursue. And again, linemen, D-line, if they let you guys through and don't block you, stop, tackle the closest guy near you to run back. They're running on the screen, got it? Nothing illegal about that long line, okay? And get ready for the option. You guys saw how to stop it now, right? All right, let's get up.
Second half is our half. Let's come back. Let's go ahead and let's take this 21-point lead and let's go ahead and win this game by 7. You got it? Hit squad on
1, 2, 3, hit squad!
Being my last away game, I mean, I'm just not going to try to think about that and just go play. But, I mean, like, you kind of get in shock in a way. I mean, knowing, like, it's your last away game because then you just know it's going to be your last home game eventually. And, yeah.
I don't know. I think it's just like this is my last chance to go on someone else's field and show them what I can do and what we can do as a team. It's just our last chance to show up at someone else's house and say, hey, we're here.
You know, I think it means more to the seniors because, you know, it's their last away game. But it means a lot to me, too, because, you know, it seems like the first couple of years you don't really have to worry about, you know, your performance, really, because, you know, it's not that, you know, highest level. You're not a senior yet. You're not the leader on the team. You know, you mess up, you try again, but it's different when you're a senior, you know. You're the top dog. Everybody looks up to you. So, you know, last away game before then.
All right. Are you leaving me?
Well, honestly, it was my last away game with a lot of my seniors, and one of the seniors, of course, being Joey, my brother. And it was kind of hard to swallow losing that game because it was with my brother, and it was our last ride together.
Okay. In my opinion, that makes me feel happy because now we have a bigger crowd and basically a bigger family to help support us throughout the last 2 games of the season.
All right, Dip.
It's going to be sad. It's always sad when it's your last bus ride with some of your best friends. That's really it. Other than that, it's just a whole nother game.
I knew that it was my last time to go somewhere. It was my last bus ride. For me and Eric, that was really important. And for the team, it was just a really important bonding period.
Knowing that you only have 2 games left in your high school football career, what is your mindset for the rest of the season?
Basically, just have fun. Just make as many memories as you can because this is the last time that you're going to get to play with a lot of your brothers. You're not going to go anywhere else with them. So these are going to be the last couple of games that we get together. Just during fall break, I really didn't expect, I expected a couple kids not to show up, but on Monday when there was only 14 kids, that really, I really took it pretty hard, and I bet coaches did too, and I'm just glad that we had everybody back.
So basically, like, during fall break, it was a lot harder than usually, like, regular practices. We ran a lot more, conditioned more, but we did get out a lot earlier than usual.
Last week was a chance for us to try and prove something of ourselves. We had two games left in the season. We have two games left in the season, and it's our last chance to make a name for Tanque Verde. Tanque Verde's never won more than four games, or more than three games, actually. And me and Jack were there for when we broke that record of three. So, I mean, it's our chance to, we have two games left to bump that number up to five or bump it up to four. I mean, it's our last chance to make a name for Tanque Verde for us seniors before we head out.
There to signify how bad you want something. Failure is a passageway to success. It's how you respond to failures or obstacles or those stumbles or brick walls that will ultimately determine your results.
Thank you. I already got my dopest clip of the night.
Huh?
I already got my dopest clip of the night.
What?
It's me walking out of like the roll top and like slowly panning up to the field all lit up.
Okay, Mark's not coming, so.
Yo, Colton, get up there!
We're never gonna back down from nobody! I don't care who it is! This is a brotherhood! And if we stand together, we can't be denied! It's a battlefield out there! But if one of us goes down, we have another, and another, and another that's ready to fight! So let's hit this field and bang him!
Woo!
Bang him!
Woo!
Bang him!
Woo!
Somebody, light me up!
Woo! We too deep! We too deep! We too deep!
Woo!
Survival verse?
Wait, I'm pretty sure none of them even know what they're talking
about.
Hey, this ref is not standing in the way today. That is awesome.
I bet you shoot that. Hey, God.
All right, let's go. His squad on three.
One, two, three. His squad.
Hey, stand your lane. No big play. Let's go. Disney.
What play are we
around when I have five linemen turning around looking at my quarterback. I don't remember that one. Can you just tell me what that's called? But you guys are better than me.
Come on, guys.
We're not that good. You guys just all on this. We have that waggle. One guy is ruining our whole play. We can't watch our quarterback. What's our rule? 7 seconds.
Hey, you guys gotta decide. Are we gonna let him put 60 on us at home, or are we gonna stop?
Let's go. Wake up. We can play with these guys. Come on.
Hey, guys.
Hey, listen. I'm an old guy that posts a long time. Here's the thing. You've worked your butts off. You've done a lot. Do you want to go through the motions, or do you want to play hard? You understand that? Do you understand that?
Yes,
you got something to say. This is your home field. Your home field. Play like you like it matters. Play like you love it. You work too hard to go out there and just
go. Let's go. Hey, pop the hell out of it. Go tackle him and get us a ball. Let's go.
Let's go back to our target and let's not give up any more points. Y'all gotta be willing to do it, man. I told you, like, I see seniors over here in their hands just doing whatever. Y'all need to come out here and be for real about this. I'm being honest, man. Some of y'all gonna sit around and lie to y'all kids and say, oh, I did this, I did that. Y'all better get out here and play, man. Have some fun while you're doing it. Have some fun putting people back on the ground. Now, Gavin, if the guy comes out, I'm tired of this QB running, man. Okay? I'm tired of running. I want you to attack the QB.
He's not what Tanya does. He doesn't deserve to wear 10.
He doesn't deserve to wear 10. Jeez. All right, let's get ready to go, man. Let's go.
Stop, Aiden. Stop right there. Wait on everybody.
All right, fellas. Hey. What's the score, guys? Hey, fellas, let's go win the second half, all right? Let's do it. Score 0-0. Let's play ball and see what we're supposed to do. Got it?
Sure.
Eric, warm them up, man.
Wait.
Eric. Wake them up, man. Let's go. Hey, let's get back to who we were 2 weeks ago, man. Let's go.
Gotta make it
clear. I ain't talking. This means we have 24 minutes. Then we jump.
Lock it up. Yo, lock it up.
Something hurts. All right. It really hurts.
Like that.
Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Y'all ready?
Yeah.
And we hit the field like offense like defense like green and black like all day like all night like it squad like I was called like and it sound like and it sound like and it sound like
let's go. We only got a game and a half left, fellas. Let's make this happen. The second half is Hawks half, got it?
Yes, sir.
Work on three. 1, 2, 3.
Work. Coach, I'm gonna need help.
We'll be right back.
Anything.
We got guys to stop the drop, we got guys to stop the trap, and we got guys to stop the sweep. Just do your job. Be great. Make big hits.
All right, fellas.
I love you.
It's time to feed the other dog, man. The other dog needs to go sleep for about 48 minutes. Been thinking about something today. I've been thinking about selfies. All you guys take selfies all the time. In my day, we call them memories. And I have a lot of memories of high school. You guys will have digital pictures. Not a day of your life if you've been alive and you haven't had digital photographs. These kids' entire life is on digital. Did you guys know that? So tonight's another chance for you to go make a selfie. A good selfie or a bad selfie, that's all up to you. But it's a selfie nonetheless, right?
Yes, sir.
Make it a good one. Make it a good selfie. When you look back on tonight, and you see the pictures in the yearbook, and you see the film, and you see your YouTube videos, and you see what you got, make it a happy memory. And that's what I want for all of you tonight, is do something that makes it so that you can't look back and be regretful. You can do that tonight. Take that positive selfie in your head, take it and take it over and over again throughout tonight. After the game, when we stand there and I take that picture with the seniors and the coaches, that's my favorite selfie because I know those young men are going to succeed in life. Because I did everything I could to make them tougher and harder, but also more responsible and to think for themselves and to be reliable. So tonight, that's what I want. Every selfie you take tonight, make it a good one. In your mind and after the game, understand?
Yes, sir.
And you gotta feed that dog, baby. When you think about it, you're gonna think about that. You're gonna learn what that means. And you slowly are starting to get that you gotta turn that on. You gotta feed that dog. You gotta open that gate and let that dog out. You gotta put the good dog away for a while, okay? When we do that, we gotta remember, stop him for a minute and get back in the huddle, right? Call him off. Let him go again, over and over again, okay? 7 seconds, that dog is loose. Hold him away for 25 seconds, right?
Yes, sir.
Can we do that?
Yes, sir.
Hey, nobody I'd rather go to war with, but let's go to war, right?
Yes, sir.
Let's not wait to start the war till the second half. Let's go start it right off the bat, got it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah.
what it feel like to do that in real life. And now I know I got it. That's the reason no ID has signed me on a dotted. But it's still visionary to the death of me. Yeah, I'm trying to make it, but I gotta find a recipe. Greatest of all time, I want the world addressing me. At the hotel, these beautiful girls undressing me. I'm trying to stay focused, I guess that's the Lord testing me. I knew as a child that this was my destiny. They do it for the limelight, but I make sure my rhyme's right. Waiting till the time's right. Smiling at my mom's like, smiling at my mom. Smiling at my mama. But where what we sipping now? We was never tripping now. We on private jets, in other words, that means we tripping now. Cause they was over there, I was over here. They was too scared, but I was facing my fears. I've always been driven, but they too scared to steer. That's why I compete with legends, mother my peers. I'm the man of the year. In the beginning, nowhere to be found when I was down. But you show up when I'm winning. Left me to drown, now I'm swimming. I do it cause I love it. The money and the women and the whips with the rims still spinning. I've been at it since the beginning. All these girls screaming logic, but I wanna hear my real name come from the lips of a beautiful woman. That's real, man. Y'all act like I'm Superman, but I can feel pain. I shit gone crazy, and yet I'm still sane. Love it when they sing to us. Been shining was bling to us. Yeah, over here, it's only been a year. I was dirt broke, now I'm ballin' like a sphere. I'm the man of the year.
I wouldn't.